Sunshine Value Farm family, welcome back to another episode of The Farm. If you are new here, you are most welcome. Please consider subscribing if you haven't already, and also turn your notification bells on not to miss out on any videos on the channel. And of course, to all our returning subscribers, thank you so much. We love you guys so much, and thank you so much for being part of the family. Thank you so much for loving what we are doing at Value Farm. You guys are gems. Well, today we are back at the farm and it's just beautiful. It is sunny. You know, when it's sunny, those are my favorite days at the farm, by the way, because the sun is out and everything is moving on so well. The animals are being fed. Everything is going perfect. Well, I also have my director on standby, who is also going to say hello to you guys and also say something to you guys briefly.
Hello, everyone. My name is Gregory, also known as Grafton. Co-director. I'm not the director here. Yes, again, I know we always say the same thing. Today, as you guys can see, it's a wonderful day. The sun is definitely shining.
Yeah.
And that's also one of the rewards of actually being in this industry, because by the time you make it here, there's very few that can go wrong once you are in a setting like this, right?
Yeah.
Mentally, you feel recharged, you know, emotionally, like the connection with what's happening here on the ground gives you all the energy you're going to need to get through the day.
True.
But the reason we wanted to actually shoot this video today was to actually take you guys what happened once you go beyond the beginner's guide to starting your farm, and then phase two, right?
Exactly.
So you've already done your homework, you've done your research, you actually already acquired your land, everything is fine,
and then you've acquired your breeds,
you've identified your breeds. What should you do, right? Where do you go from there?
Mm-hmm.
So the first thing most people would tell you as you get into phase one,
yeah,
the number one mistake most people make, they go through the first portion of starting the farm, right?
Yep.
They actually have the structures, they have the animals, they have everything else, and then they think their job stops there.
No.
In reality,
that is just the beginning.
Exactly. You're just getting started onto the journey.
True.
Because you can raise all the goats you want, all the pigs you want, you could have 1 million eggs on your farm. Guess what? If you didn't work just as hard to identify a market, a mm-hmm. sector, clients who would like to purchase your actual product, guess mm-hmm. what? You're in business, but you're not really in business, right?
True.
Because you're never going to be able to eat 1 million eggs yourself, right? This is not a hobby. Now, if you want to have a hobby farm, that's something else.
Yeah.
By the way, you should commend yourself, pat yourself on the back, the fact that you're already taking multiple steps to even get to this point.
Yeah.
So for those of you who are at home, on the road, wherever you are that's actually watching this, congratulations on taking the step to becoming a farmer. You know, that says a lot about you as an individual.
That is so true.
Because by the time you make that decision, you have to do a lot of soul searching, right? And the fact that you came to the conclusion to actually get to the point where you can get into phase two
mm-hmm.
is tremendous. So now phase two should start simultaneously the same time you're running phase one. What do we mean by this, right? You don't want to wait until your chickens, if you are into poultry, or if you're into piggery, or if you're into goats, you don't want to wait till the point where you have your chickens about to lay, a week from laying, to start identifying where you're going to sell your eggs, right?
Exactly.
So the moment you acquire your land, you build your structure, at the same time,
mm-hmm.
you should be talking to the local people, talking to all the local supermarket
suppliers.
If you are savvy with tech, then mm-hmm. you should be all over social media.
That is
so
true.
You should be on Instagram. You should be on YouTube. You should definitely be writing blogs about your company, talking to your local leaders, talking to the LC. Guess what? Here in Uganda, you'd be surprised. Even in the village, mm-hmm. there's actually a head of agriculture in almost every district you live in.
Yeah.
So wherever you are, maybe look into whatever resources that are available to you. So priority number one, think about this like real estate.
That is true.
Market instead of just location. If people don't know who you are, that your company exists, then you're going to suffer. And
that
that's the last thing we want you to do. So when you're coming out of the gate, you want to have momentum. So as you're starting to put your stakes in the ground, you're building your fence, you're promoting your animals. You're promoting what your company is going to be doing. You're promoting what you're going to specialize in. And that at that point, people will have you at the top of mind. So when they need eggs, when they need chicken, they're like, oh my gosh, there's a new farm coming up.
Coming up.
Let me go see Madam Tina. Mm-hmm. Or Mr. X, wherever you
that
are.
That is so right? true. Yeah, what I also think about how you can be able to deal with marketing your products, marketing what you have. Remember, we always tell you guys that you need to do your research, you need to visit other farms as well. So whenever you go to different farms as well, you have to learn more about how they are running their business, where they get their market, where they sell their items. So most cases when you go to these farmers, of course, that is a question you have to ask. Is there a market? Mm-hmm. And where do you sell this? So we visited some other farms as well, like Nguru Farm, and we asked about the fish farming. We are so curious about how it gets market for the fish if you're going to start fish farming. Of course, he will tell you there's a market this side. He will tell you the prices. The person will also give you maybe the procedure that you're supposed to follow in case you wanted to start selling. So before you start, of course, you know the market is there. How am I going to go about it? So it is all about creating relationships with the people that you go to the farms you go to for your research, that you'll be able to also identify the potential market for your products at your farm. So that is one of the things that most people really have to take consideration of as well.
I agree. And to dovetail on that bit of information, you want to have the ability, you don't want to be a pharmacist as a farmer. Mm-hmm. And what do I mean by that, right? People that go into pharmacy for a reason.
Yeah.
They don't like dealing with people.
Okay.
And I would say that's where you as the owner of your farm, though we much rather be dealing with our animals, mm-hmm. you need to be able to get out of your shell.
Yeah, that
you
is
You need
true.
To actually be out there pressing flesh, mm-hmm. meeting the people, going to the market.
Yeah,
make
that
sure
is true.
That you remain humble. Just remember, most places you're going to go, 99.9% of the time, the default answer to your service is going to be a no.
Yeah.
Don't get discouraged. You stay through. You stay true to what you believe. And guess what? Sometimes the toughest critics in the beginning are going to end up being your biggest clients.
That is so true.
I can tell you guys right now, like the one company, the one of the major companies that we distribute to, by the time I actually got to the meeting, that day we were literally at the entrance to the actual distribution center.
Yeah.
And I almost asked the driver to turn around and let's leave.
Yeah.
After driving there an hour to get to this place, because the experience getting past the gatekeeper, getting to the decision maker, it was so difficult. It was so tough, right? But at the end of the day, we got in the door, we sat down, the energy was different. Mm-hmm. And I'm so grateful that my partner here kept us from leaving, mm-hmm. because that meeting has truly been a game changer for us, right?
That is so true.
And another thing too, you never know where your market leads are gonna come from.
Yeah.
So if you're fortunate enough to actually know a vet, whether they're licensed or not, right? You want to be in touch with these people, because if they know the quality that you have, mm-hmm. at times, that's the best form of advertisement, right?
Yeah,
word
true.
Word of mouth, referrals, warm referrals, those are the best options. You want your brand to be professional. You want your brand to be, you want to be synonymous with the best, okay. right? So whether you're small, on your way to becoming big, and it's okay, you could be like the smallest fish in the pond, your mindset should always be, you're going to be where everybody else is. In fact, you're going to surpass them.
Yeah,
you
true.
Know? Don't be cocky. Walk around with that quiet confidence. Just know that God is with you, or whatever God you happen to pray to. Okay? As long as you believe in yourself, believe in your process. And if you have a plan, if you follow phase one, mm-hmm. guess what? You're already ahead of the game. Because most of these best other farmers out here, no matter how big they are, most of them don't even have a plan of action.
That is true. I was helping a friend of mine yesterday. Yeah. You know, she started a small business. So she was asking me, please help me. How am I going to get market for my products? You know, she's been working in an office for a long time, but her contract expired. So she's at home. There's nothing she's doing. So, of course, I advised her earlier on, like, to do something, you know, small that she can start with for now, at least to give her something than just sleeping at home. So yesterday she opened officially her small business and she was asking me, how am I going to market? How am I going to approach people in different offices? I told her you should go and give them samples. The good thing, the packaging, you have small samples, give them to your sample for free. That is how you can be able to begin to impress them. If you know that your quality is really very good, take for them, they will definitely buy for you in bulk, because these people already have their suppliers. Because most places that you go to, they will tell you, ah, we already have someone already supplying. She did that already yesterday, but she was so overwhelmed. Then I also told her to put on her WhatsApp statuses, to put on Facebook, to put on Instagram, to promote her products. She called me later on in the evening. She was like, oh my God, I couldn't believe what has happened. Most people are calling me. They want the detergent. I was like, what? You see, this is how you do it. So social media is also one of the things that you really need to also use so that you can be able to market your product. So in case you have maybe your animals, you have your birds, you have everything at the farm, at least use social media to also promote what you have. And of course, talk more about them so that people get to know about it. Then another thing is about still people who are working in offices and maybe consider farming as a side hustle. It is time that you really made your side hustle a real business, because these side hustles here are the ones that give even more money than money that you earn in offices. So what I would really advise anyone out there, if you focus so much maybe in your farm, how it's running, and also you approach it positively, trust me, you're going to earn more money from your farm.
Okay, actually that's a really good point. But I know some of you that are watching us right now might not be media savvy. You might not have the ability for you to actually get on Instagram and Facebook. It's okay. Talk to your grandchildren. Talk to your nieces and nephews. And in many instances, if you're not fortunate to have that extended family, guess what? You might be able to get resources and relationships within your church. You know, when it comes to marketing, guys, it starts with the people you know.
Exactly.
And the people you know are going to be a number one advocates, right? If they know you and respect and trust you as an individual, and they respect your vision as a business owner, then, you know, you can always approach them to ask them to keep you in mind as they refer possible clients to you, right? But then when you get that lead, you better make sure you treat it like it's going to be your last.
That is true.
Every single lead that comes to you, you have to treat it like a golden nugget and take the absolute best care of that client. Because the last thing you want to do is to get a referral from a friend or family member and you don't follow up.
I know.
Because that will be the last thing you're going to get from that person.
That is so true. Let me tell you guys something. When we're trying to market our products here, at first, we tried going to different places, especially now for the pigs. We went to different butchers. We went to these restaurants, you know, asking them whether we would supply to them. It wasn't an easy journey. So many people, wherever we would go to, they would tell, we already have our suppliers. Or they would tell me, we shall give you a call. Do not be discouraged. Most of them will definitely get back to you. Some of them will get back to you. Some of them will not.
There's a very important process when it comes to actually outreaching for business. You have touch points, right? You're not going to get a yes with the first call.
Yeah, true.
You're not going to get a yes with the second call. So you have to temper your expectation. You know, you got to put on that Teflon armor. You know, this is business. Business is the actual bloody sport.
True.
Because you're not the only one in the marketplace. You have competitors
all around. Competitors
all
over.
Right?
Yeah.
So you can't take this like, oh my gosh, I called two people. They both said no. All life is over. You can't approach it.
Then you give up just like that.
You can't approach it that way. You know what your goal is. If your goal from the moment you start your farm, whether you're doing goats, when you get your first 3 to 4 goats, and in your heart and your mind, your businessman states, 36 months from now, I'm going to have 3,000 goats. You got to approach it with the same vigor. Right?
True.
You know, we always say every journey starts with one step. You have to take that first step. And the first step for you, you literally have to do like a shuffle. Right?
True.
Step one and step two have to happen almost simultaneously. So don't be discouraged. You know, just know the biggest supermarket in your neighborhood, the biggest farms in your area have to start with their first steps
first
as
step,
well.
Yeah, true.
So, you know, that's what I have for you guys. And in terms of if you want to get to the point where you're distributing, we should have covered this before, but call this point number four, right? So now, just like when you're starting your farm, you need to decide whether or not you're going to be breeding for breed stock, right? Or you're going to be breeding for meat distribution. Well, now that you enter phase, the second level of your business, you need to determine whether or not you're going to go after the wholesale distribution market
or retail.
And then within retail, there's a caveat there. Retail, meaning you can get yourself to the supermarket, to your local stores, or you literally can go direct to consumer where you grow your stock from your farm, and then you open your own little butcher shop, right? Where you're actually selling directly to the customers, you're doing home deliveries. There's so many ways to reach customers, guys, because especially now, with food prices getting to the point where they are,
mm-hmm.
if you produce it, if you talk to the right people, they're going to take it.
True.
You know, just make sure that you go as a professional. When do you take samples to your possible buyers, right?
Mm-hmm.
You don't take it on the first call.
Yeah.
You know, you don't bring a half of a cow. You're not going to bring pork ribs with you or your best chops on the first meeting with someone.
No.
You know, when you get to the point where you're discussing pricing, right, and they actually want to see the quality, maybe for the second meeting or the third meeting,
yeah,
right, when you literally are about to really truly get to the phase where contracts are being discussed, money is being exchanged potentially, yeah, right, and they want to see the last product,
mm.
that's where you should bring in samples. We would typically save this for another video, but I think we should also think about this too.
Mm.
Now,
point it out.
What you need to do, right, when you get to the point where you're selling to your customer, number one, you also need to figure out your pricing.
Yeah.
And how do you come up with that pricing? Pricing is determined by, for each animal on your farm, you need to know exactly what you put in to each of those animals. And then, let's say, for example, per pig, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's say how, based on the feeding program that you have, you're following the commercial structure of feeding your pigs. Each pig you're going to have here is going to cost anywhere between 275 to 300,000 shillings each.
True.
In many instances, based on pricing of materials in your area, it might be 300,000 to 400,000. If a little bit more, a little bit less, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now with that price, plus the price you're paying your staff, right, then you need to determine, are you going to make 30% more? Or are you going to make 15 to 25% more? If you want to have a viable business, your margin should at least be 35% or higher, right?
Wow.
So that's how you determine your price. And also, you want to see what your competitors are doing.
True.
You don't want to price your product so high that nobody's going to come to you. But you also want to find that happy medium, especially when you're new to the market. You might have to take a haircut initially just so that people actually get familiar
mm-hmm.
with what you bring to the table.
True.
And as you start to pick up the market share in that area, then you can adjust your prices, right? Based
yeah.
on where, how quickly you actually going through your stock.
Wow, that is really so nice. That's what every farmer out there really wants to hear, because you know the market prices are differing from different places,
yeah.
but at least you have to compare from your fellow farmers, from the location where you are, so that people do not get scared with the prices that you have at
That's
your
true.
Farm. So let's talk about value addition. That is another way that you can definitely also make money or also market your other items at the farm. Because if you have the pigs, if you have the goats, how are you going to improve? How are you going to make money from your products in different ways?
By the time you get to the point where you're thinking about value addition,
mm-hmm.
my dear farmers, you have made it.
Yes.
When you can get to the point where you've actually been in the marketplace for some time
mm-hmm.
and you actually have enough money set aside, your brand in your area,
true.
To in your community, people know who you are. You're the goat guy, or you're the
pig guy,
lady, whoever,
poultry guy,
right? By the time you get to the point where you want to come up with value addition,
mm-hmm.
that's like every one of us. That's our dream.
Our dream.
Right?
Every farmer's dream.
So now it depends on the industry that you're in, specific subsectors of farming. You know, let's say, for example, if you have poultry, right?
Yeah.
There's a lot you could do. It's not just the eggs. It's not just the meat, right?
Mm-hmm.
So then the byproduct of that, right? Some of us, I'm sure you've been to the supermarket where you see that they actually have the eggs that they're selling in the carton.
Yeah.
Right? It's just the pure egg whites.
Yeah,
right?
True.
So you can actually separate your eggs, right, from the actual shell. Because some people like myself, I only like to eat
you
the egg
like
whites.
The,
I don't
the
eat
egg
the yolk, right?
Yeah.
So I'm not going to buy like a dozen of eggs only to throw out every single yolk,
yeah.
right? I'm going to look for the actual carton with the prepackaged egg whites because that's what I like.
Wow.
So there are options for you to actually explore. You know, you could also make chicken sausages, you know. It's
mm-hmm.
all based on what your area needs. Don't just start wanting to add value to something that doesn't really
that is not familiar.
You understand?
Mm.
So you need to find out, like, hey, if you can't find any chicken sausage where you live,
mm-hmm.
maybe you might want to become the chicken sausage guy
mm-hmm.
or the chicken sausage lady, right?
Mm, yeah.
So then, you know, use your brain, keep your eyes open, be open, right? And don't be rigid.
True.
Do not be rigid.
True.
You've
true.
Heard me say this so many times. Be flexible, be humble, keep your head down and work hard,
yeah,
before you know it, you'll be in the clear. Beauty and value addition, the reason you all want to get to that point,
uh-huh,
is because when value addition, your markup is significantly higher. So whatever you would sell, let's say, for example, 1 kilo of pork, and the market right now is around like 10 to 15 thousand shillings, right?
Yeah.
However, if you decide to make sausage to sell to one of your vendors, right?
Mm.
Instead of selling at 20 or 18,
mm,
you could sell 1 kilo of actually sausage, right? Processed sausage.
Processed
that you
made,
one. Anywhere from 48,000 to 56,000 shillings per 1 kilo.
Per 1 kilo.
So when you get to that stage, life is good. You just have to identify which entry point you want,
true,
what you can handle. Do not take on too much too soon,
mm-hmm,
right? So that's why you do these things in phases.
Okay? Wow, that is really so amazing. Guys, I know most of you have been really asking us, Tina, because I remember so many people asking me, Tina, you've taught us everything, taking care of our pigs, taking care of our everything at the farm, how to start, but you never tell us about the market. I hope this video has been really very helpful to you, because at least we've discussed so many things of how you can be able to tackle this area of market, how you can get market for your items at the farm.
And also, we know some of our videos, we're very fortunate that we have a wonderful farming community who happens to follow us on YouTube,
yeah,
as we follow many of you.
Yes. YouTube.
If there's any of you out here that have additional ideas on this topic,
mm-hmm,
we did not cover, please, that's why the comment section is there.
Leave in the comment section.
Leave a comment below. You know, help out your fellow farmers, help out the community. Let's just grow together. That's what's the most important.
That is the most important thing, because we are learning from you. You're learning from us. We are sharing ideas. Whoever comes to read the comments. By the way, some people just come and read the comments so that they can get and also learn better. So if you have your idea, do not be selfish. Just leave it down below so that we can also learn from you. Because we always tell you guys, farming is a learning process. We learn every day.
And one last thing before you go.
Mm-hmm.
As you get to this journey.
Yes.
You know, quite often people make the mistake, whatever career path that they choose, they let their careers add validation to who they are.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't count for farmers, right?
True.
This is not just what we do, this is who we are. If you're into farming, you wear it on your sleeve, you wear it on your, like this in your heart, it's what you were put here to do.
True.
So don't let anyone deter you. Just remember, this is not an industry invalids get into. You know, this is not an industry failed people get into, you know. Yes, it might be a low entry point for some people.
Mm-hmm.
However, there are people out here like Tina, like myself, who went to school, who had corporate careers, who have the ability to get other corporate jobs and just make lateral moves, right? But we decided to come into this because, of course, there's a greater purpose. We wanted to help our community,
true,
address food insecurity. But let me tell you guys this, if farming and acquiring farms and farmland is good enough for people like Warren Buffett, one of the wealthiest people in the world, if Bill Gates and some of the wealthiest investors around the globe is investing in farmland
that
and
is
farming,
true,
then it's good enough for me, okay?
That is true.
So again, on this journey, it's not going to be easy.
Mm-hmm.
But in life, anything worth having is worth working for it.
That is
because
true.
If it was very easy, if it was that easy, everybody would be a farmer,
yeah,
you know? And then the value that we bring wouldn't be so highly appreciated. So thank you again for joining us. Don't forget to comment, subscribe. As my partner would say, tell your friend.
Tell a friend. Follow us on social media as well, guys.
Value Farm UG on IG.
Yes, Facebook, still Value Farm UG. And of course, we have also our Patreon account. The link is in the bio. Then also we have the membership. You can also join so that you can support Value Farm. We have PayPal if you want to sow a seed, if you want to support Value Farm. Please, and you want to see progress, much progress at the farm. Please, just support us because, you know, without you guys, we wouldn't be here because we always come here because of your motivation, because of your inspiration as well. I know most of you say that we inspire you, but you also inspire us, by the way, big time. But we love you guys so much. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Do not forget to subscribe. Most of you have not really subscribed to the channel yet to watch the videos. Analytics still show us that 72% of you watch the videos but not yet subscribed. Please, just subscribe. It's free of charge. You don't have to pay any coin, any penny to subscribe. Just subscribe so that even our videos get recommended to other people. That is the beauty about it. But we love you guys so much. Till next time. Bye.